Now this seems strange because first in section 9.2 it was the newsfeed class that insisted on a display method in post, and now that there is a method in post, only the display methods in the subclasses message post and photo post are executed, and the one in the class post is not executed. To understand this, there is a rule that says that the static type is used at compile time, while at runtime the dynamic type is used for method invocations. So there is a procedure on how the method invocation works, and to better understand it, this procedure that is called method lookup or method binding or method method lookup, and we can look at an example where there is a variable v1 of declared type photo post, and a photo post object is stored in it. So there is no inheritance in this case, and it's a simple method invocation. So the steps to invoke the method when v1.display is called are first variable is accessed. V1 is accessed. Then the object stored in V1 is found through the reference to the object. Then the class of that object is found through the instance of reference, and the display method is found inside the class and is executed. This is straightforward, but when the inheritance is introduced, these steps have a different behavior. So if now PhotoPost has a superclass, because in the first scenario, it didn't have any superclass. And now, if it has this superclass post, display method defined in superclass and no a display method defined in photo post, so there is no overriding. The steps 1 to 3 are done in the same way as scenario 1. So the variable v1 is accessed, then the object stored in that variable is found through the reference, then the class of this object is found through the instance of reference, and then the photo post class. So a superclass of this class is searched, and a method display is searched inside that superclass. And if no method is found in the superclass, then goes all the way up into the inheritance hierarchy until the method is found. So it will search until the object class, and since there is no compile error, it means that at runtime this method should be found somewhere in this superclass. Some superclass should have this method. So the post has this display method, and that is what will be executed. Now when there is inside the photo post class, so that now there are these two methods display, one that is defined subclass and one that is defined superclass. The method lookup will look exactly like the first scenario. So the variable v1 is accessed, then the object stored in it is found, and then the class is found, the class of this object is found, and then the method is found and executed from this class. And the implementation will be of this class. So there are some observations to be done, and in particular at compile time the static type is used, and at runtime only the dynamic type is used. So it doesn't matter if the variable is of a superclass, only the subclass will be subclass method will be executed. So the overridden method will be executed, and the superclass method will not be automatically executed. That's because the method lookup goes from the from the subclass, from the looks first at the dynamic type. So it starts from the dynamic type. So from the lowest point in the inheritance hierarchy, and so that's why the listing of newsfeed is incomplete and will be fixed in the next section. It's because for this reason that at runtime only the dynamic type is what is used for the method lookup. That's the reason why there is the display method of the superclass is not called, but just the one overridden by the subclass. And this will be fixed in the next section. There is a difference between the dynamic type and the static type. Method lookup will behave exactly the same.